Okay guys, so today we will talk about quasi contract. Okay, so what is the basic meaning of a quasi contract? So it is a contract implied in law. Okay, implied in law, which is actually an order given by the court. Okay, so it is implied in law and it is an order given by the court. So what do you mean by the phrases implied in law and order given by the court? So it basically means, for example, if I want you all to understand easily, is there's this party A and party B. Okay, so they are in some terms of business, okay, but they don't have a particular insurance or any agreement. Okay, so if there is any dispute between A and B and they don't have any proper agreement to back it up, so what can be done regarding that? They can't be fighting their whole lives, right? So maybe person A wants 10 lakh rupees from person B. And person B is not willing to give that. So what will happen regarding that? So in this case, they can go to the court and ask for help. So if they go to the court for any help, they will create a quasi contract. Okay, this contract is not in favor of any particular party. Okay, it is not a partial favor. So they are not partial towards Mr. A or Mr. B. No matter whoever files the case first. Okay, so that doesn't come into consideration. So here we can say that if there is no agreement between both the parties, then the court can help them by making a quasi contract so that they can come into a midway. Okay, there is a midway where they can adjust. So maybe Mr. A wants 10 lakhs from Mr. B, but then Mr. B is not in the state of paying. So maybe they can come in an agreement in a midway of 5 lakhs, where Mr. A is also willing to take the 5 lakhs and Mr. B is able to pay off the 5 lakhs. Okay, now since you all have understood the very basic and simple example, so let me make it clearer. So, the contract is made by the court, as I said. So basically an implied in order, okay, implied in law contract. So when is it created? When there is no official agreement. Okay, no official agreement where? Between the parties. So as we took the example of Mr. A and Mr. B. So there is no official agreement, no official agreement between the parties of Mr. A and Mr. B. So there might be any disputes regarding any goods or money. As in the previous example, I said that Mr. A demands 10 lakhs from Mr. B, which he is not able to pay or he is not willing to pay. Okay. So there might be a dispute regarding goods as well. So they might be having any kind of business regarding cars. Maybe, okay, let's catch cars. So after the business is shut, Mr. B is willing to give Mr. A 2 cars out of it. And he wants to keep the rest, maybe 20. Okay. So, but then Mr. A doesn't want that, he's not happy with the will, so he wants a 50-50. So, regarding these agreements. Okay, there was no proper agreement maybe. So there maybe initial agreement was regarding the business starting. Okay, like whatever investment is there and all that. But a lot of people don't really think about when the business goes down. What if the business is stopped? What if they complete the they completely want to abandon the business? So what about them? So they did not have any agreement, official agreement, as we can see. So what will they do now? They will have to go to the court for help. So then the court will create a quasi contract that comes to the midpoint. Maybe he wants that Mr. A is given 10 cars and Mr. B is given 10 cars. Or maybe Mr. B is at a fault. Maybe the investment of Mr. B was less and the investment of Mr. A was quite more. So maybe Mr. B will be getting 2 cars, what he actually wanted Mr. A to get. So he'll be getting 2 cars and Mr. A will be getting the rest. Okay, one thing to keep in mind here is that the court is not unjust towards any of the groups, towards any of the parties. Okay, it won't unjustly want Mr. B to give up all his money or all his cars. Okay, that won't be the case. The recovery money will be a mid-range amount. Okay, not really. So as basically first we had said about the 10 lakhs. So it won't be like Mr. B has to give all his money to Mr. A or Mr. A will have to give all his money to Mr. B. That won't be the case. They will reach a midpoint. They won't be unjust to anybody. They won't leave anybody bankrupt. Okay. So that is a part of this quasi contract, that you cannot be unjust towards any party. You cannot be biased. You cannot be partial towards any party. Okay, so I'll explain it more with an elaborate example. Okay, let's take an example of a girl named Teresa. Okay, she has a brother named Eric. Okay, now in this case, Teresa has a huge backyard. Okay, she has a huge backyard in her house and Eric wants to build a greenhouse over there since he knows that Teresa likes greenhouse. Okay, so what does he do? He wants to give her a surprise of making a greenhouse in the backyard. I'm just writing it as G and H, so that it's short and easy to understand. So he has this plan in his mind and he does not tell Teresa about it. But the land is in Teresa's name. So remember that. So now what he does is he contacts a builder named John. Okay, he contacts a builder named John and he is willing to build the greenhouse for it. Now, the catch here is Eric does not have enough money. So he wants Teresa to pay for it. But since it is a surprise, he won't be telling Teresa, right? So what happens? They don't have any legal agreement regarding this. Okay. So now, after all the plannings and everything, John builds the greenhouse. So the greenhouse is checked off. So that is done. Now what happens? Teresa, when after seeing this, she is not happy with the initiative. So, not being happy with it, she is not willing to pay any money. So, what happens in this case? Eric is totally out of money. He is done with the thing. He has already said that he doesn't have the money. He won't be able to pay for it. So, whose loss is it now? Obviously, John's. Because he is the contractor. He has paid for all the building, for all the labor, and all the costage is John's now. So, what happens? He basically files a lawsuit, a civil lawsuit. Against Teresa. So after stood against Teresa in the court. There is no other choice but to make a quasi contract, which the court will ensure that it is made. So in this contract, even though Teresa has no legal agreement with John, or Eric does not have any legal agreement with John regarding that Teresa will pay the bills for the greenhouse that is made, but the greenhouse is already made in Teresa's property. Basically, Teresa likes or not likes the greenhouse, it is made in her property. So the court might ask Teresa to pay for all the expenses of John, because John over here has nothing to do with his family, has nothing to do with the greenhouse. He was just asked to build it and he just needs his money back. He's just a contractor, a normal contractor. So that is what the case here will be. So the court won't be unjust, obviously. It will ask Teresa to pay John. And after that, Eric and Teresa can settle on some kind of agreement, because that is between the brothers and sisters, that is between the house affair. So the main problem here is Eric cannot pay, hence Teresa will have to pay John all the expenses of the greenhouse. So this is what a quasi contract helps you to do. Because John over here did not have any contract, did not make any agreements, nothing. And he put all his investment into the greenhouse. He did not take any advance from Eric. So he was caught over here. He was facing a problem over here regarding the money. And now, due to the court's agreement, due to the quasi contract, by goodness gracious, because of him, Teresa has to pay all the money to John. So this was the short brief of quasi contract. I hope you all understood the topic well. And thank you so much for watching.